In this video, I will show you how to take a Blu-ray disc and shrink its contents down to about 90% of its original size using Handbrake and the H.264 codec. You might be thinking, hang on a second, didn't you just do this last week? Last week, I used the H.265 codec, which is what you need to use if you have a newer 4K UHD TV and a newer media player like an Apple TV 4K. But not everybody has that. If you have an older 1080 HD TV or an older player that can't play H.265 like a WD TV, you will need to use the H.264 codec. Once you have ripped your Blu-ray to the desktop, drop it into media info to see what you are dealing with. In my case, you can see the raw source data file is 33.8 gigs, has 7 audio streams and 6 subtitle tracks. You can also see that the video track has a data rate of about 23 megs every second. That's huge. We will reduce these numbers significantly. Now, open up Handbrake and drop the file in. You'll find yourself on the summary tab. There is not much to do on this tab apart from set the format to MP4. You can leave the Align AV Start checked and uncheck Pass-Through Common Metadata. Next, it is on to the Dimensions tab. Everything in here is good at the default. Just make sure that cropping is set to automatic, the resolution limit is set to 1080p, anamorphic is set to automatic, and borders is set to none. On to the Filters tab, where again, the defaults are perfect for what we need. Interlace detection should be at default, deinterlace should be set to decome, and the preset should be default. These settings ensure that regardless of what type your source file is, your encode will have nicely combed progressive video. Now, the Video tab. We need to set the encoder to H.264, our frame rate to same as source, and change it to constant frame rate, as not only will older players not be able to handle a variable rate, you can also introduce skewing of the audio and video tracks, where what you see and what you hear aren't aligned. Set the encoder preset to very slow. I know this sounds bad, but trust me, this is where the good quality comes from. Set the tune to film, the profile to high, and the encoder level to 4.1. Now, adjust the constant quality slider to 24. Down the bottom, there is room for additional advanced options. There is an additional code in this video's description, or you can head to the webinets and view the full article that goes with this video. There is a lot of additional info you may be interested in, and you can also find the advanced options code here. Highlight and copy the code, and then paste it into the advanced option box in Handbrake. Now, it's onto the Audio tab. For maximum compatibility, if your video already has an AC3 or Dolby Digital soundtrack, select that, as this is what we are aiming for. As you can see here, the closest I have is a DTS 5.1 soundtrack, so I will choose that. Next, select AC3 as the codec. Set the bitrate to 448, change the mix down to 5.1, and the sample rate to 48. Next, subtitles. To remove subtitles, click the grayed out cross at the right hand side on Windows, or on Mac, just select none from the drop down. For chapters, you can leave this option checked if you wish to create them, or if you don't want them, just uncheck it. Now, return back to the summary screen. Make sure to save the file somewhere easy to find and give it a unique name. Press the green encode button and let Handbrake do its thing. Okay, my encode is finished and I now have a new file on the desktop. Close out of Handbrake and drop the new file into Media Info to see how we did. You can see we have dropped the file size from 33.8 gigs down to just under 2.6. That's a reduction of 92%. How cool is that? We have also dropped the video rate from 23 megs a second down to just over 2 megs a second. A massive improvement. Thanks for watching, and if you like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. See see you in the next one.